गुड मॉर्निंग प्रकृति। गुड मॉर्निंग दिनेश, प्रतिभा, लिशा, एवरीवन। ओके, सो आई थिंक यू नो दैट वी स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर ऑल्टरनेटिंग करंट, राइट? So we started a new chapter, alternating current. As the name says, the current will be not a constant, but it will change both in magnitude and in direction periodically. Periodically matlab after some time the values will repeat. Understanding or not? Mathematically, how will we write any alternating current or alternating voltage? We write it like, if it is current, we write I equals to I naught sine omega t. If it is voltage, we will write V equals to V naught sine omega t. Again, please remember, these are not the only alternating current and voltage. There are many other kinds also, but this is the most simplest one. These are called your harmonic currents. Harmonic, okay? So for your board syllabus and most of the entrance syllabus, we are going to concentrate on this kind of alternating current, which can be expressed by sine function, or you can use cosine function also. Okay. Now quickly tell me, what are these values called? What are these values called? This value or this value? Specific name I have given last class. Peak value. Very good. So this is the peak value. Okay. You can also say maximum value. You can also say amplitude of voltage. But if you say amplitude, you have to say amplitude of voltage. This will be amplitude of current. Okay. And what was this angle called? It was called phase. Very good. Now, when you want to add alternating quantities, it is better to use a technique called phasor technique. Phasors, the name phasor, see, it reminds you of vector, no? Vector, phasor. So I'm not saying these are vector quantities. No, they are not vector quantities. They are not going in some particular direction, right? So they are not vector quantities, obviously, but they can be manipulated. They can be algebra of this quantities will be more easy if you use the same technique as you did in vectors. So what we do is we represent this kind of alternating quantities by a quantity called phasor. Just like vector, we used to draw a line with an arrow. For representing any alternating quantity, we can draw a line with an arrow. Okay. The length of the line will give you the what? The peak value. Okay, so if let us say this arrow represents this current, then you will write this peak value as I naught. Okay, this length of the arrow will give you peak value I naught, and the angle it will make with some reference line, that angle will give you phase. Okay, students, so this is what we call phasors. Very, very useful. Later you will see the use of this phasor when we have to find, you know, sum of many alternating quantities. Okay, later you will see, don't worry. But I hope this phasor diagram is clear. Yes or no? So the length of the arrow will represent the peak value. The angle will represent the phase. That's it. That much only we have to know. Then I told you, if you calculate the average value of this current, then average value of this will be average value of this into average value of this. What is average value of sine function? Zero. So average value of current will be zero. That does not mean current does not produce any effect. Put your pinky finger in the socket. Don't put much, simply I'm saying. otherwise some case may happen. Okay, if you put your pinky finger in the electrical socket, you will realize, okay, that the alternating current has effect or not. So alternating current has effect, especially the heating effect. What effect? Heating effect of alternating current is always present, just like DC. So to find the effect of the alternating current, we are not going to use average. What we are going to do? First, we are going to square the current. Then we will take the average. But we will not be satisfied with this, because this will give you effect of square of current. So what we will do? We'll take square. So this is what we call, as Chiranjeevi is saying, IRMS current. So this is called RMS value of current. Whenever instruments will measure AC current, they always measure RMS current. So this is the reading of AC emitters. Okay, so RMS values are the readings given by your AC emitters. Please keep that in mind. Also, in your question paper, when they will say AC of 2 ampere is flowing, that 2 ampere will be your RMS current. Please keep that in mind. Now quickly tell me, IRMS, how it is related to the peak value? It is peak value divided by IRMS is equal to peak value divided by root 2. Again, this is only true if your function is like this. If your function is sine function. If it is not sine function, then this will not be true, remember. As I told you, for board syllabus and for most of the entrance questions, these are the currents we will discuss, mathematical functions. This kind of mathematical function we will use, sine function we will use. Therefore, this formula will be valid for this kind of current. So last class up to here we did. Now students, when you apply a DC voltage, you can use battery. So batteries will give you DC voltage, constant voltage, right? This is the circuit symbol. Similarly, when you apply AC voltage, the source we will represent in this way. So if I draw this kind of circuit symbol, then this is the circuit symbol for AC source. AC source, okay, which we have already studied in previous chapter. Yes or no? AC generator we studied, no? So the whole generator we will not show in the diagram. We will just draw this diagram. So this symbol means AC generator, or you can say AC source. Clear or not? So please remember. So we'll start today's class now. So the first topic for 3 marks is AC applied to resistor. AC applied to resistor. So this is for 3 marks, very common question again. For board exams, very common. So what we are going to do, we are going to take a resistor and we are going to connect a AC source. And what we are going to find is the relationship between the voltage and the current. That is what we are going to study, AC, okay? So this voltage will be AC, so it will be V equals to V naught sine omega t. So there is no point writing plus here, minus here. Why? Because it will keep on changing. Because this sine will become positive, negative, right? So there is no point writing plus, minus like that, because that will keep changing. But whenever this is plus, this is minus, current will be this way. Whenever this is plus, this is minus, current will be this way. Okay, so instantaneous voltage, applied voltage will be V equal to V naught sine omega t. By the way students, omega is your angle covered by time taken. Now here angle covered means what? when the time taken is time period, when the time taken is time period, one complete oscillation of the AC, then what, how much angle it will cover, how much phase it will cover in one complete cycle, how much phase it will cover? 2 pi, right? Everybody understood that, right? If this is your AC, if this represents time, then this is called time period. Time period. Okay, time period. Time taken for one oscillation. But if this represents phase, phase, then we write here 2 pi. Okay, because this is pi, this is pi by 2, this is 3 pi by 2, this is 2 pi. So when the phase is 2 pi, when the phase is 2 pi, time taken is time period. And what is 1 by time period? 1 by time period is frequency of the AC, frequency of the source. So please remember this formula. Already we have seen this kind of formulas before also. Okay. So we are applying this AC voltage. Okay. Now my aim is to find the current. So if this is the voltage at time t, what will be current at time t? Instantaneous current. Well, this is resistor. Since it is resistor, we can use which law to find the current. If you know voltage, which law will you use to find the current? Ohm's law. So I can write V by R. Please remember, this law is applied at a specific time. So you can't use voltage today to find current tomorrow. If you are using voltage now, you can use this law to find current now, not 5 seconds later. Understood? No. Because these are instantaneous value. These two will keep changing. This is fixed. This is fixed. So what will be current equal to? Substitute this voltage. V naught sine omega t divided by R. Now I ask you, what is the maximum value of this current? Maximum value of this current will be when sine is 1. That time what will be maximum value? V naught by R. Everybody agree? V naught by R. So how will I write now this? I equals to I naught sine omega t, where I should mention I naught is equal to what? In place of this, I have written I naught. No, so I have to write V naught divided by R. So that's the derivation, because I found the current. So this is equation 1. This is equation 2. And this is the relation between the peak current and the peak voltage. Finish it. Done? Okay. So now try to compare equation 1 and equation 2. If you see the phase of voltage, what is the phase? Omega t and sine function. What is the phase of current? Omega t. That means these two will be in what phase? Same phase. So that is very, very important to remember. So let me make a note. In a pure resistive circuit, pure means what, sir? Pure means in this circuit there is only resistance, no capacitor, no inductor, only resistor. Okay, so in a pure resistive circuit, comma, we see current and voltage are in, what phase I should write? Same phase or different phase? Same phase, because both has omega t, omega t. Are in same phase. Okay, students, and you have to draw one diagram called phasor diagram. So one phasor diagram, if you draw, so let us say this is your reference line. So if this is the phasor representing the voltage V naught, this length will be peak value and this angle will be phase for the voltage, right? What was the voltage equation I already wrote? No, V equal to V naught sin omega t. Current will be where? Here only or somewhere here or somewhere here? Here only or somewhere else? There only or somewhere else? Current phasor. There only, because the phase is same, the angle is same. Of course, the peak value, why it will be same? Peak value of this and this need not be same. Anyways, they are different quantities, no? So this value may not be same, but this angle is same. So it can be larger or shorter. So let me write larger. So this is your I naught. So one arrow represents the voltage phasor, another one represents the current phasor. So students, you may have to draw this, not you may have to. If they ask this question, how will they ask the question? They will say, show that in a resistive circuit, current and voltage are in same phase. Like that they will ask. So you will have to start from voltage equation and derive current equation. After deriving, you should see that both the equations, if you observe, the phase will be same. And they will also mention to draw phasor diagram. So 2 mark for derivation, 1 mark for this diagram. Okay. Now look here. Suppose you draw the phasor diagram, not this way, but suppose I draw this way. This is V naught. This is I naught. Allowed or not allowed? If I write this, will I get marks or not? What do you think? Instead of drawing this diagram, suppose I draw this diagram. Will it be okay or not okay? It will be allowed. Okay, why it will be allowed? Because you know this omega t, this time is something which keeps changing. The time keeps on changing. So these arrows are not going to stay here. These arrows will keep rotating. They will keep rotating. So when it is here, I have taken the picture and I have shown you. So somebody can take picture when it is here also. So when these arrows will reach here, that time you can take picture and show. So even this is correct. Okay. So whichever one you want, you can draw. Don't draw both. So this is called phasor diagram. Another diagram is called waveform diagram. Waveform. So waveform means basically it will show you the shape of the variation, the shape, how it is changing. So let me write the formulas once. V equal to V naught sine omega t. I equals to I naught sine omega t. And I naught is V naught by R. So this is what I have derived. No. So waveform diagram means you have to plot voltage and current in the same graph. In the same graph with time. So voltage you can see V naught sine omega t. I have chosen sine function. So when t is zero, what will be your voltage? V naught sine zero. Sine zero is zero. So voltage will start from here and go like this. Let me do this much only. Okay. So this is your voltage. Current formula you see at time zero. This is also sine only. So current when time is zero, current also will be zero. So current will also go this way. but it may be more or less, the peak value. Understood, students? So one of them is voltage, another one is current. So they will reach maximum together, zero together, negative maximum together, zero together. So they are always oscillating in same phase. Understood or not? At the same time, both of them are maximum. At the same time, both of them are zero. At the same time, both of them are minimum. Negative maximum, I can say, or minimum, I can say. Understood what I'm saying? The maximum values are not same, obviously. This is V naught. This is V naught. This is I naught. So maximum values are not same, but the time when they are maximum, that is same. That is the meaning of same phase. This they will not ask, but still I'm showing to you. So if they say phasor diagram, this one you have to draw, not this one. Okay. Before I do the other two now, first I applied AC to what? Resistor. This one was applied to resistor. Then I will apply to capacitor. Then I will apply to inductor. Inductor means that solenoid. After that, we will apply to all of them. That is the whole chapter. Okay. But before I do that, I want to give you one 2-mark question. Okay. If AC voltage is given by, useful for CET also, V equals to 310.2 sine 100 pi T where V is in volts, T is in seconds. Then find number one, VRMS, number two, frequency. So I want RMS voltage, I want frequency of the alternating voltage. I have given voltage. Same question they can give for current. Same technique. So if you look at the equation, how we write alternating voltage? V equal to V naught sine omega t. Correct, na? So by comparing, what will be your V naught? This value or not? 310.5. What will be units? Volts. This V is unit, okay? Don't get confused. Sorry, two. So this will be your peak voltage. What they want? RMS voltage. So RMS voltage is what? Peak voltage divided by root 2. So 310.2 by root 2. How much will you get? Root 2, you take 1.41. 220. Okay, so this is the reason why I get this number, because I wanted RMS voltage 220. Do you know what is the special thing about this number? The government of India is giving us electricity or not? Of course, we are paying money, but we are getting the electricity. The voltage which is given to us, the AC voltage, is 220 volt. So when I say AC voltage is 220 volt, AC voltage is 220 volt. I've told you, whenever people say AC voltage is 220 volt, it means RMS value is 220. RMS value is 220. What about frequency? So by comparing this standard equation with this equation, V naught is this much. What will be omega from the equation? also omega will be what? This is your omega, no? Omega t. Correct or not? So omega will be 100 pi. Now what I gave you formula for omega? 2 pi divided by time period. 1 by time period I write frequency. So what will be frequency? Pi, pi cancel. Therefore frequency will be 50 hertz. This is also standard in India. In India, okay? If you go to US, the values are different. That is why if suppose you go to US and you buy some, let's say, one nice hair dryer, then that hair dryer, when you bring it and if you put in our power supply, your hair dryer may burst, may catch, you know, electrical short circuit may happen. That is because their AC voltage standard and ours is not same. Okay, so we will discuss these things later when we will study about transformers. So if you want to use a device which was made in US, in India, if you want to use, or vice versa, then you have to have transformers. So I hope everybody understood this simple problem. Okay, so before we applied AC to resistor, and one important thing we found was peak value of current is equal to peak value of voltage, applied voltage divided by resistance, right? Which means if resistance is more, your peak value of current will be less. Same thing will happen, you have to change, okay? So if your peak value of resistance is more, your current will be less. Is it clear or not? This part is clear or not? This is just your Ohm's law. And that is why we say this opposes current. This is why we say this opposes current. So the more is the resistance of the circuit, the less will be the current. And that is important to realize now, because now we are going to do for capacitor and inductor. So we have to see in capacitor and inductor, who will play this role? Who will play the role of resistance in capacitor and inductor? That we have to see. So next topic you write. AC voltage applied to capacitor. We will start with capacitor because we did capacitor before doing inductor, right? So this kind of circuit will be called, students, pure capacitive circuit. Pure capacitive circuit. No resistor, no inductor. AC source, V will be V naught sine omega t. So again, starting will be same, instantaneous voltage V equals to V naught sine omega t. Now I want current. This capacitor will have capacitance. My aim is to find current, remember, because I have to study the relation between AC current and AC voltage. So to find the current, can I write like this? Can I write like this? Is this the formula for finding current in capacitor? Can I write like this or not? Obviously, no. This C is not resistor. C is not resistor. So what we have to do, we have to go and remember in capacitor what we used to calculate. So in capacitor, if you remember, once you apply a voltage, the capacitor used to get charged. And when it is getting, once it is charged, the charge at any instant, instantaneous charge, Q is equal to C into V, super, C into V. So if this is the voltage at time T, this is the charge at time T, remember. So C voltage is V naught sine omega T. So if you observe the AC voltage and the AC charge, you can say, because this charge also will change. If you see the charge, you can see they have same phase. Their phase is same. Sine omega t, this also sine omega t. So remember that for your CET exams, charge in the capacitor, voltage applied to the capacitor will always have same phase. During their oscillation, these two will have same phase. Okay, sine omega t, sine omega t. But I'm interested in current, remember. Instantaneous current. Already we have discussed this in current electricity chapter. So if the charge is Q at time t, how do you write current? Q by t or dq by dt? Q by t or dq by dt? Q by t we use only for steady current. Q by t is used for average current or steady current, remember. Since it is instantaneous current, we have to write dq by dt. Okay. This diagram we don't need now. Let us use this part of the board. No, I hardly use this part. So what we will do now is let us substitute this Q. In board exam, you have to do systematically, okay? I know now you people are expert in differentiation, but still you have to do it stepwise. C and V naught are constants. You know differentiation of sine AX is A cos AX. So this will be C V naught omega cos omega t. Right? Now, if I ask what is the maximum value of current, what will you say? This quantity. Yes or no? Because cos maximum value is also 1, just like sine. So maximum value of cos is 1. So maximum value of current, this quantity will be your I naught cos omega t, where I naught is C V naught omega. C V naught omega. Till here, understood, students? Okay. Now let us compare the voltage equation. Let me write voltage once more. Please write equation 1 here. I think I forgot to mention. Write equation 1 here. Now, if you look at voltage and current, you may think, oh, omega t, same phase. You may think like that, but it is wrong. This is sine, this is cos. So you cannot compare their phase directly. What you have to do? You have to convert cos into sine. After converting cos into sine, then you have to compare. See, you cannot tell Sachin Tendulkar is better than Sania Mirza, no, because they are in different fields. So you cannot compare directly right now the phase, because this is sine, this is cos. They are from different fields. So once you convert both into sine function, both into, let's say, cricket, then you can compare Sachin with somebody. So what we will do, we will try to write this in terms of sine. But there is a slight confusion in that, which when I was studying, I never understood. Teacher did not tell properly. So let me write this current here. Now listen carefully if you want to thoroughly understand. Voltage is this. Don't write this one, okay? This one we have written already. Now, to write this into sine, all of you know that sine 90 plus theta is what? Sine 90 plus theta is what? Oi, say fast. Sine 90 plus theta is minus. Huh? Hey. Sine 90 plus theta is second quadrant. In second quadrant, sine is positive. So it is sine 90 plus theta is cos theta. Second quadrant, na? Second quadrant cos is positive. What about sine 90 minus theta? Sine 90 minus theta. That is also cos theta. Okay, so keep this in your mind. Now, while writing here, I'm going to use this one, not this one. And why, you must ask actually. So cos theta I can write sine 90 plus theta, which I will interchange and write theta plus 90. I can do that, right? A plus B is same as B plus A. So I'm going to use this result here. So I'm going to write sine omega t plus 90. Now the reason why I'm not going to use this is because once I have written the phase, listen carefully. Once I have written the phase of voltage, which is omega t, I want to compare with this phase, the phase of current. So I want to know the phase of current is more than omega t or less than omega t. That I want to know. So phase of voltage is omega t. Angle is called phase, this angle. I want to know current is in front of this or behind this. So that's why we need to write the phase of current in terms of this phase. Matlab, is it omega t plus 90 or is it omega t minus 90? So if you want to know that way, you have to use this one, not this one. Why, sir? Because if I interchange this one, will it be same? Will it be same or minus sign should come here? Minus sign should come or not, first you tell. Because if you interchange this, minus will come here. And that minus you can write here. So this one we will use later when we do inductor. So this is the one I'm using right now. Okay. So now students, observe equation 1 and 2. From equation 1 and 2, what do you see? Who is having more phase? Current or voltage? I or V? Who has more phase? I. Voltage has phase omega t. Current has omega t plus 90. So what we write is, from equation 1 and 2, we see in capacitive circuit, in capacitive circuit, of course AC circuit, current leads, L-E-A-D-S, leads voltage in race, current leads voltage in race or in what I should say? In phase. So current leads voltage in phase by what angle? 90 degree. Or you can say pi by 2 radian. That is your wish. No need to say both also. So this is very important to remember. Okay, you will get confused later. I mean, was current leading or voltage leading? Like that you will forget. So you need to keep importance to this fact that if it is only capacitor, current will lead. Capacitor, current will lead. That much you have to remember. So in capacitor, current leads voltage. Current will be ahead of voltage in phase by 90 degree. So this is how the question will be asked. They will ask you, show that in capacitive circuit, current leads voltage by 90 degree phase like that. This one we have used. Okay. This one we have not used right now. Okay. Then phasor diagram they will ask. Phasor diagram. So how will I draw? If I say my voltage is here, V naught. Okay, let me draw the, let's say this is reference line. So if voltage has phase omega t, this is voltage. This length represents peak value. Then current will have phase how much? Omega t plus 90. And remember, in whenever you do angles, this way anti-clockwise angle is taken positive. Okay, so your current will be here. Why? Because this angle should be omega t plus 90. Understanding, students? Now you can draw this way for your exam, for board exam. Instead of drawing this, you can draw this. If voltage is here, current will be here. This is easy also, and this is the one actually, you know, teachers, they will ask for this diagram. So this one you draw for exam. Understood the diagram? Because this keeps rotating, I told, they keep rotating because time will keep changing. So as it is rotating, when this current will reach here, this voltage will be here. All right? Yeah, so when this voltage will reach here, this current will reach here. Everybody understood the phasor diagram? Okay. Let me keep this one, okay? Because now we will use this one. Okay. So the third derivation is AC applied to inductor. AC applied to inductor. No, that doesn't matter, Zainab. That will depend on the value of many things. See, I naught equals to, what was the value of I naught we got? V naught C V naught omega. Check once. Check once. This is the value of peak current we found. Check once. Yeah. So whether this is more than this numerically will depend on this. But asking also, no students, asking also whether this is more than this is actually wrong. Why it is wrong? Because these are different quantities. I cannot say my height is more than your mass. I cannot say my height is more than your mass like that. That is no meaning on this. So there is no meaning to compare the values of current and voltage. Yes, you can compare their phase, at what angle they are from the reference line. So phase you can compare, but comparing the volt magnitudes is not meaningful. Okay, let us now discuss AC applied to inductor. So inductor we draw like this. Resistor has resistance R, capacitor has capacitance C, inductor has what? Inductance L. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to apply this inductor to a AC source. Again, AC. So same thing, same derivation. Starting from voltage. So instantaneous voltage V equals to V naught sine omega t. Equation 1. I want current, but directly current you cannot find. So let us see what is going to happen. Since the current here will keep changing, why it will change? Because it is alternating voltage. As the current keeps changing, the magnetic field produced here, the magnetic field produced by this solenoid, that will also keep changing. As the magnetic field will change, magnetic flux will also change. And if magnetic flux also changes, EMF will be induced in the coil. Yes or no? And the EMF induced in the coil E is from Faraday's law, minus L di by dt. Minus L di by dt. And you can see what you want is here. It is hiding here. We want current. No, current is sitting here. Remember, this is EMF. So, matlab, this also will act like a battery. This is also like a battery. Of course, it is not a constant voltage battery, but this is also applying some EMF. This is also applying EMF. But this EMF will always oppose this EMF, right? So, the net EMF will be V plus E. And that will be equal to zero. Why it will be zero? Can anybody tell me? How do we write? Usually net EMF, how do we write? Equal to. If there is resistance in the circuit, net EMF, how do we write? If there is R in the circuit, net EMF we write I into R, yes or no? But here, this is what kind of circuit? This is a pure inductive circuit. So there is no resistance. So this should be zero. That basically means that this V is V naught sine omega t. And this E is minus L di by dt. That should be zero. This is your applied voltage. This is the back EMF. Back EMF. So to maintain the current, the applied voltage should be, if you take it this side, L di by dt. Okay, students. Now this you can easily remember without doing all these things. How, sir? To maintain the current, yesterday when I derived the energy stored, what I told, to maintain the current, your applied voltage should be equal and opposite to the back EMF. Remember or not? The applied voltage should be equal and opposite to the back EMF. Yes, Ashwini is remembering. So, same thing, here your back EMF is minus L di by dt. So your applied voltage should be equal to this, but opposite to this. So it should be plus of this. So this is very easy way to remember. So now we have to find current. As you can see, current is hiding inside the differentiation. If something is in the jail of differentiation, how do you remove it? By integrating, right? So what we have to do, we'll cross multiply. So di will be equal to L, I'll bring here, V naught by L sine omega t dt. So first what I have done, I have separated the variables. Two variables are there, students, current and time. So di, I write separately, and all the other things cross multiply dt, L here separately. Then we integrate. So integral di equals to V naught by L is constant, integral sine omega t dt. Okay. Till here clear? This cross multiplication may be slightly, I don't know. So try to see carefully, dt will come here, L will come down. Okay. So now, integral of di will be I, V naught by L. Integral sine omega t will be minus cos omega t by omega. Correct or not? So integral sine omega t is minus cos omega t by omega, okay, not into omega. Into omega is in differentiation. In integration, we have to divide by this constant omega. So now if I rearrange, it will be V naught by L omega minus cos omega t. So if you want to know maximum value of this, that will be this only, right? When this is minus 1. When this is minus 1, this minus minus will become plus. That time this will be maximum. So this maximum value is this. I naught minus cos omega t. And what I should write for I naught? Where I should mention I naught is v naught by L omega. Let us compare the phase now. For that, let us remember how we wrote voltage. V naught sine omega t. And how much we got current? I naught minus cos omega t. Now, what we are going to use here is the fact which I told you before. Sine 90 minus theta, we know is cos theta. But I want minus cos theta, so I will interchange these two. Sine theta minus 90 will be minus cos theta. So this way, if I write, no, I will come to know the phase of current is more than phase of voltage or less than that. I will come to know. That is why I'm interchanging and writing. So this will be written how now using this, remember. So don't see this. Using this here, minus cos theta will be I equals to I naught sine omega t minus 90. This is your equation 2. Right, till here we have derived. See here, from here I continue. This one you don't write, just to compare I wrote. So from equation 1 and 2, this is equation 2. What was the phase of voltage? Omega t. What is the phase of current? Omega t minus 90. Minus 90 means it is leading or it is lagging behind. It is lagging behind. So what we should write? In pure inductive circuit, current lags behind voltage in, not race, remember, there is no race, in phase by 90 degrees. Everyone try to draw one phasor diagram yourself. I will draw it. So how will the phasor diagram look like? The phasor diagram will look, if this is the phasor representing voltage, then the phasor of current will be here. Why? Because it should be behind, because angles will time will increase. No, so when time will increase, this angle omega t will increase this way. So this is always in front of this. So this is behind. So if this goes here, this will come here like that. So this is always behind this by 90 degrees. Is it clear, students? So any one of them may come. Again, all these three are very important, but all these three are for 3 marks only. So you may think the second and the third are little longer than the first one, but they ask for 3 marks only, each one of them. Okay. So the next important topic is what happens when all of them are there. So till now what I did, I studied what happens when resistor is given AC source. What happens? Current and voltage are in same phase. Okay, so we will study that properly now. Separately we'll study. So only resistor, current and voltage, this is known, okay, are in same phase. And peak current was given by peak voltage divided by resistance. By the way, students, can I write this way? Can I write this also? Or no, sir. This is allowed. This is how it is allowed. Or can I write? I can write because I can divide by root 2 both sides. So if I divide by root 2 both sides, this will become IRMS and this will become VRMS. So remember, we can write this way also. Okay. Now this is what we found for resistor students. For capacitor, we found current leads. So current leads voltage by 90 degree. Current leads voltage by 90 degree. And we found I naught equals to I naught equals to what we found? C V naught omega. Now listen carefully. Here also I want to know who is playing the role of resistance, because I want to know who will oppose current in inductor, sorry, in capacitor. So who will oppose current in inductor? That I want to find out, alternating current. So right now you can see everyone is in the numerator. So what I will do, listen carefully, I will write this V naught by, basically what I'm trying to do, I will tell you, I'm trying to write this equation in the same way as this equation. So I'm going to write this as 1 by C omega. Check once. Fine or not? Because 5 you can also write 1 by 1 by 5, na? 5 you can also write 1 by 1 by 5. Now the reason why I'm doing this way is, now I came to know this is the guy, this is the guy who will play the role of resistance. So this is the guy who will oppose current in capacitive circuit. So capacitor also opposes AC current, but its opposition is given by this quantity, not R. We don't call it resistance. So we will give a name to this. First we will give symbol, then we will give name. So this one we will write XL. XL, capital X, suffix L, because it is XC. Sorry students, it is capacitor, no? XC. So where XC will be your this quantity, and this is the fellow who will play the role of resistance in capacitive circuit, and we call this quantity capacitive reactance. I will give the definition after this definition I will give, but first you write the name. So this quantity who plays the role of R in capacitive circuit is called capacitive reactance. So the moment the current tries to change, the capacitor will react. That is why it is called capacitive reactance. And that opposition is given just name, capacitive reactance. Definition I'll give later. But this is something important I wanted to tell you. Symbol is XC, which is equal to 1 by C omega. Okay, this is for resistor, this is for capacitor. Done. Now inductor also will do. Okay. For inductor, what we found? Current lags. Current lags voltage behind voltage by 90 degree. And the formula which we derived, check once, for peak current. For peak current, the formula which I derived just now was V naught by L omega. Is it correct? Just check once. Yeah. So who will play the role of R? Here no need to do anything. This L omega is sitting in the denominator. No. So this will play the role of R. So we are going to give a name to this. First we will give a symbol. XL. Where XL will be L omega, and that is what we call inductive reactance. Please write down. So first remember this lagging and leading part, who lags whom in what circuit, that you have to remember. and who plays the role of resistance in these two circuits, that you have to remember. So some 1 mark, 2 mark questions may be asked. Okay. What is the reactance? Well, first let me give you a definition. Okay. So capacitive reactance. Simple, already you know. The opposition. Please don't write the resistance, because that resistance word we are using for resistor. The opposition to the flow of AC by capacitor is called capacitive reactance. And unlike resistor, resistor is what? Resistance, rho L by A, rho L by A. So once you decide the material, once you decide the length, once you decide the area, resistance is fixed. But this reactance, capacitive reactance, is not a fixed number. It also depends on the frequency of the source, because omega is there. And you all know omega is 2 pi frequency. Correct, na? So capacitive reactance will depend on frequency also inversely. Done. You are not replying so that I will do less topics or what? Okay, yes. Then next I will write here only, students. Inductive reactance, how will you write? The opposition to the flow of AC by inductor is called inductive reactance. And the formula for inductive reactance and the symbol is XL, formula is L omega, and omega is related to frequency of the AC source. That remember that coil which used to rotate, no? So how fast you are rotating the coil, depending on that you will generate voltage with different frequency. So your reactance offered, your opposition offered by inductor will depend on the frequency also. And how it will depend? Directly proportional to frequency. Please remember this. In the previous case, it was, I forgot to write, but it was inversely proportional to frequency. So if the frequency is more, inductor will oppose the current more. Please remember that. Whereas capacitor will oppose less if frequency is more. If frequency is less, inductor will oppose less, but capacitor will oppose more. Sometimes they will ask graph. So XC, let's start with XL. XC, no problem. Versus frequency. So you already know XC is 1 by C omega. So 1 by C, 2 pi F. So you know these two are inversely proportional. So when frequency is zero, what will be this? Infinity. So the graph will go to infinity. And similarly, when this is infinity, this will be zero. So when frequency is infinity, this will go to zero. So the graph will look like this. Okay. So this is called rectangular hyperbola. Rectangular hyperbola. Just name of the graph. Now. What about if they ask graph for inductive reactance and frequency? You know the formula. L omega, omega is 2 pi frequency. So it is directly proportional. So when frequency is zero, this is also zero. So the graph will go like this. This is y proportional to x graph, no? And the slope will give you this number, slope. So if the inductor is more, your slope will be more. Inductance, if it is more, slope will be more. Done, students? Okay. For DC source, what is capacitive and inductive reactance? So for DC source, battery, let's say. So if you have a DC source, what will be capacitive reactance? For DC source, what is the frequency? What is the frequency of DC source? DC source doesn't change only. Since it doesn't change, frequency will be zero. Therefore, if frequency is zero, capacitor will offer infinite opposition. This is zero means this is infinite. Whereas inductor will offer zero resistance. Zero, not resistance, zero. It is resistance only. English word is resistance, but zero opposition, you can say. So basically, if your current is constant, capacitor will not allow the current to flow because it offers how much resistance? Infinite. How much reactance, I should say? Infinite. Whereas for inductor, it will just act like a wire. The inductor will just act like a wire with no resistance. Why? Because current is not changing. If current is not changing, there will be no back EMF. Understanding or not? Okay. So please keep in mind, capacitor will not allow DC to flow. Inductor will happily allow DC to flow, because it will offer no resistance. Inductor will offer no opposition. However, please be careful. When you just start the switch, when you close the switch and you wait, current will not become instantly 2 ampere. It will take some time. So during that time, current will flow in capacitor also. That is called the what period? The charging period. So once the capacitor is fully charged, then I am saying the opposition by capacitor will be infinite. Because during the time it is getting charged, which is very small actually, that time the current will has to flow. Na? So I remember one Facebook memes I have seen where they asked why capacitor does not allow DC to flow but AC can flow. See, you can see DC current cannot flow. Why? Capacitor offers how much resistance? How much opposition? Infinite. So the picture they have shown is like this. DC cannot flow because DC will come like this. No, so it cannot flow. But AC can flow because AC can go like this. So some nonsense things they are saying, showing in the picture. Don't get confused with that picture. This is not the way current flows. No, this is what? This is how the current changes with time, not how it is moving in space. Okay. Remaining 20 minutes, we will do one 5 mark derivation, then we'll stop the class. Very important derivation. 5 mark means always important. So look carefully. The name of the topic is AC applied to LCR series AC circuit. Now in exam, obviously they don't write topic, no, they will ask question. So what they will ask under this topic is, they will ask you to derive the formula for something called impedance. They will ask you to derive the formula for impedance. Now what is impedance? Later we will see, but quickly let me tell you. Whatever opposition resistor gives to current, whether it is AC or DC, is called resistance. Whatever opposition resistor gives to current is called resistance. Whatever opposition inductor or capacitor gives, that we call reactance. If it is by inductor, we call it inductive reactance. If it is by capacitor, we call it capacitive reactance. But when it is due to resistor also, inductor also, capacitor also, or inductor and resistor, or resistor and capacitor. Matlab, when there is resistance also, reactance also, then the total opposition is called impedance. Understood? Later I will give definition everything. So impedance is basically the total opposition to AC by resistor, inductor, capacitor together. So they will ask you to derive this formula. So let us start. Okay, so this time we have L, we have C, we have R. L, C, R. For board syllabus, only series is important. But for JE Advanced, parallel also we will have to do. But later we'll do. L, C, R. Then we connect AC source. This AC source will have a voltage V naught sine omega t. V naught is what? The peak voltage between this terminal and this terminal. Yes or no? Because this is between these two. Nah? These wires are resistanceless. These wires have no resistance. So there will be no potential difference here. So if this is 10 volt, this is also 10 volt. If this is 100 volt, this is also 100 volt. So whatever is potential difference here will be here. So V naught is the applied peak voltage. V naught is the applied peak voltage of AC source. Okay, omega is the angular frequency of the AC source. Okay. Now, since they are in series, you expect the current, whatever current is flowing at any particular instant, that current to be same because it is in series. So what we will do, we will try to find the voltage here, voltage here, voltage here, 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 here. And we will try to express these voltages. Once we find these voltages, we will try to find the total voltage here between these three. Now you may say like this, if voltage here is VL, voltage here is VC, voltage here is VR, where VL, VC, VR represents the peak voltage. Okay, let me write this way. V naught L, V naught C, V naught R. That will be better, no students? So these three represents the peak voltage here, here, here. Now some of you may think, oh, V naught will be equal to V naught L plus V naught C plus V naught R. This is a very common thinking. Why? Because this is what we have done before. Agree or not, when we had resistors in series and I applied a DC voltage, V. How we wrote V? V1 plus V2 plus V3. That is how we found equivalent resistance. Remember or not? करेक्ट ना. हाँ बट नाउ वी कैन नॉट डू. द रीजन व्हाई वी कैन नॉट डू इज बिकॉज दिस आर एसी वोल्टेज एंड वी डोंट नो देयर फेज. दे मे बी इन सेम फेज, दे मे नॉट बी इन सेम फेज, दे मे बी इन ऑपोजिट फेज, दे मे बी 90 डिग्री इन फेज. सो वी हैव टू सी द फेज डिफरेंस ऑल्सो. Therefore, we cannot directly add them like we did for DC, remember. Because these quantities are AC, they will have phase. So, what we will do, we will try to first discuss four resistor. See, current will be same because it is series. So, let us say I naught is the current. Let me rub this part. Let us mention, let I not be the peak current. Then for this resistor, I can write V not R equals to I not into R. Yes or no? Because when I did only resistor, what formula I derived? I not equal to V not by R. So if I cross multiply, I will get this. Only difference is instead of V naught, I have to write V naught R because this is for resistor. V naught is not the voltage here, students. V naught is the voltage here. This part everybody understood. Cross multiply this. But you must write V naught R. Okay. Don't write I naught R also. Because I naught is same everywhere. I naught is common everywhere. Okay. And you know current and voltage are in same phase. So this information also we have to give in exam. Okay. For resistor. Okay, this is for resistor. For inductor, let me write for capacitor first. For capacitor, what we learned, V naught C will be I naught XC. Yes or no? Why? If you remember, I told you I naught will be V naught by XC. In capacitor, XC will play the role of R, I told. Reactance, capacitive reactance will play the role of R. So like this you have to write. Just check the formula, you will understand. And here, current leads voltage. So I will write voltage lags behind current. I know I wrote before current leads voltage, but right now I am writing voltage lags behind current. Reason I will tell by 90 degree. The reason why I am writing this way is because since these three are in series, students, current will be same or not everywhere. Since current will be same, it is better to take current as the reference and then express the voltage in terms of current regarding the phase. So for resistor, voltage and current are in same phase. We know that. In capacitor, what we learned, current leads or current lags. In capacitor, current leads or current lags. What did we learn? In capacitor, current leads we have learned. So in capacitor, current leads means voltage will lag. So I am writing voltage lags behind current because I want to compare each voltage with current. Why? Because current is same for all of them.
For inductor, what formula I will write like this? V naught L is equal to I naught. Sorry. Yeah, V naught I naught into XL.
And this already you know, no? The role of resistance will be played by inductive reactance. And here in inductor, what we studied, current lags. So voltage leads.
And this voltage leads current by 90 degrees.
So nothing new, students. Whatever we have learned, same thing we are putting them together.
This you don't have, you don't write. This one not needed for exam. This one not needed.
Just remember who plays the role of R in capacitor, who plays the role of R in inductor. And you know in series voltage will not be same. So I have given different symbols. This is voltage across resistor, peak value. Voltage across capacitor, peak value. Voltage across inductor, peak value. Done? Okay.
So finally, what we have to do, we have to draw a phasor diagram for all of them. So what will be the phasor diagram? This is the most important part of the derivation. Your teacher will see this diagram very carefully.
Okay, phasor diagram. So look carefully. Again, as I told, current is same everywhere. So current we will take as reference.
So this is current phasor.
Okay, where will be the voltage across resistor?
Same only. So this is voltage, peak voltage across resistor.
Okay, students,
so this length will give you this peak voltage, this length.
Now, came to, after that what I wrote? Capacitor, no? In capacitor, what we studied? Current leads. So voltage lags.
So voltage across capacitor will be here. Voltage across capacitor.
Okay, 90 degrees. Because you know current leads, so voltage lags. And in inductor, what we studied? Current lags, so voltage leads.
Voltage leads. So this will be perpendicular, you draw please. V naught L.
Now students, one of them may be bigger than the other. So that doesn't matter which way you draw, that is your wish. It may be equal also, but that is a very special case. So you can now very clearly see, students, that this voltage, this voltage, this voltage, none of them are in same phase. So therefore, to find the total peak voltage, total applied voltage, you cannot simply add them. You cannot simply add them because they do not have same direction as such. Direction, what I should not say, phase.
They do not have same phase.
So how to find the resultant voltage, the net voltage? We will use parallelogram law and vector addition.
So you can see these two are in what phase?
These two are in opposite phase. So they will simply subtract.
So V naught L plus this will give you V naught L minus V naught C. And that will be, let us draw this much. So this will be V naught L minus V naught C.
Everybody understood this part?
It is like saying, if this is 10 Newton, this is 4 Newton, resultant is how much? 6 Newton here, no?
6 Newton here, like this we write. Same technique of vectors we are using.
That is why this is very powerful. After finding total of this voltage and this voltage, which is this much, I have to find total of this and this, remember. So what I will do? Parallelogram I'll make.
Parallelogram I'll make.
And this diagonal I'll draw. So that will give me the resultant voltage, peak voltage, which I'm writing V naught.
So to derive the formula in exam, what you do, write letters O, A, B, C like that. Okay, so from diagram you can write,
from figure,
use Pythagoras theorem,
OB square should be equal to OC square plus BC square. Pythagoras theorem, OB is length of this phasor, which represents the applied voltage, that resultant, the net voltage. So the net voltage is this. OC represents the voltage across resistor. So this is V naught R. And BC is same as AO. Agree or not? And AO is resultant of this and this, which is V naught L minus V naught C. So V naught L minus V naught C. Also. Then let us substitute the formulas from the first three equations of this derivation. What was V naught R? I naught into R.
Remember or not?
Whole square. Plus.
What was V naught L?
I naught into XL. Minus I naught into XC. Whole square.
These formulas you have understood, no? How I wrote from the first three equations. V naught R, I naught R, direct Ohm's law. V naught L, here also direct Ohm's law you can apply, provided you consider this as resistance and this as resistance. Almost done now.
So then I can write this as I naught square R square. Plus,
here I can take I naught common, yes or no?
So I naught common square. What will be left? Bracket XL minus XC whole square.
I naught common, then square XL minus XC whole square.
This is your peak voltage applied square. Now here, I can take what common between these two?
I naught square, I can take common.
What will be left? Here R square plus XL minus XC whole square.
Correct now?
So finally, what will be my V naught?
Take square root.
If you take square root, this will become I naught. And this will become square root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square.
Done, students? Done. Derivation is done now. Almost done. Okay. Now listen carefully. When there was only resistor,
the peak voltage was I naught into R.
Remember, when there was only resistor,
peak voltage was I naught into R. When there was only capacitor, it was XC. And when it was only inductor, it was XL.
Remember, right? And I told
this plays the role of resistance.
Matlab, it opposes
current. Yes or no? Because if I write this one this way, you can see if this quantity is more, current will be less. So these three quantities, they oppose current when it is resistor, capacitor, inductor.
When all of them are there together, we found this formula. Yes or no? Yes or no?
So if impedance Z, which I write Z, is the net opposition to AC by LCR circuit.
So if impedance is the net opposition to AC
by LCR circuit, then I should write V naught is equals to I naught into what?
If R is the opposition, we write R here. If XL is the opposition, we write XL. If XC is the opposition, we write XC. If all of them are there together, we are calling that impedance, I told. That we will write Z.
This is equation 4.
The first three you write 1, 2, 3. This will be 4.
Then this will be 5.
So from 4 and 5, if you compare the formula, what will be Z equals to? This impedance will be this. No, this will be impedance.
So root over R square plus XL minus XC whole square.
So this derivation will come for 5 marks. So you are not going to simply add them like you do resistors in series.
Root over R square plus XL minus XC whole square.
If I interchange this, will the answer change or same? If I interchange this, same impedance or different impedance? Same only, because there is a square here. So it doesn't matter whether you have XL minus XC or XC minus XL. Thank you. Revise all these topics for tomorrow. Oh, tomorrow MCQ. Monday. Thank you. Thank you.